Welcome to Hobbytron TV. My name is Nook, and in this video I'm going to show you how to assemble and repair the Mini Orion drone. So the Mini Orion actually comes ready to fly. You'll see the RTF on our website and on this product. It is ready to fly. All you have to do is connect the battery, put some batteries in the remote, and you're ready to take off. Blade guards are not mandatory, but highly recommended if you're going to be flying through trees in the house or anything of the sort. So I'll show you how to put these on. So these rotor blade guards, they're made to protect the blades of the Mini Orion. And how you connect these is you look at the center circle piece of this guard and you'll find a letter printed on there. And what you do is you match this letter up with letters that are on the Mini Orion. You'll find those letters on these little pieces that stick up near the blades, this white part right here. On top, it will say either A or B. In this case, I picked up a B rotor guard, and so it will connect to the front left B of the Mini Orion. Then you'll line these screw holes up. They have little pegs where the screws will stick through and connect to the Mini Orion into holes below the rotor blades. So once you got those lined up, give it a firm push down, it should snap into place. Go ahead and repeat that for the other three guards. Pro tip, if you find one corner, the other guard with the same letter goes in the opposite corner. And boom, there you go. You have all four guards put into place. But of course you need to connect them with the bag of screws that you'll find in the plastic bag with the instruction manual. Using the tiny screwdriver that comes with the Mini Orion, go ahead and place these screws in the screw holes that I was talking about lining up with the holes in the drone itself. And now you're good, right? No, we gotta get the battery in. The battery. Okay, so on the bottom of the Mini Orion, you'll find where the camera is and that one-axis gimbal that you can tilt up and down. But in the back side, or the opposite side of where the camera is connected, you'll find a little grating area. What you can do is just take your finger, press that guy in, grab one of those holes, and that'll pop right open. So inside, you'll find a red connector connected to a red and black wire. What you're going to do is you're going to take the rechargeable battery that comes with your Mini Orion and line up the flat side of this connector with the flat side of the connector on the drone. Sliding those into place, you'll feel it click into place. And then inside of the drone itself, toward the bottom, you'll find an empty cavity where the battery can be stored during flight. And there's enough space in the back for the connectors to sit comfortably right there. There you have it. Your Mini Orion is now powered up, and all you have to do is put four AA batteries into the 2.4 gigahertz remote. You can install the batteries through the back. You'll have to remove a screw at the top, and then a diagram inside will show you which way the batteries go, which is pretty standard for most battery compartments. So you went out, you flew, and you wrecked. Good job. No, it happens to everybody. Let's say you broke one of these propellers. I'm going to show you how to replace that. So on the propeller itself, you'll find a screw in the side. The screw is what's securing this to a rod that connects to the motor inside. By taking the tiny screwdriver that came with the Mini Orion, go ahead and unscrew the screw that is locking that propeller into place. I ended up having to take my rotor blade guard off in order to replace the blade itself, so you may have to do that, but if you have smaller fingers than my giant hands, then you'll probably be able to do it without taking that off. All right, and once you have that screw undone, you can just pop this propeller right off the top. It slides right off. Then go ahead and find the same color blade so that you don't lose track of the front end while you're flying around. Then line up the hole on the propeller with the hole that's on the rod. And then you can go ahead and put your screw back in and attach the rotor blade. Now let's say you're having trouble lining up the hole of the propeller and the rod. The screw just won't fit inside. What you might have to do is remove the light casing on the bottom in order to push the rod up and give yourself enough room to line up those two holes. What you need to do is just remove the screw on the bottom of the motor, set that aside, and what you can do is you can actually push the rod itself to pop out this light casing. So then you just press that rod up and you can line up the holes perfectly. carefully attach your screw, and then we'll need to replace that bottom piece, obviously, to protect the gears and the LED lights. So all you have to do is put that white piece back in place, drop the screw down inside, and voila, you have your rotor blade replaced and you're ready to fly again. Now, if you're looking for an unboxing or review of the Mini Orion drone, go ahead and click this annotation here. Stay tuned to Hobbitron TV.